Hello everyone, this is Pratyush from Proxlight, and in this video I will be showing you how can you create modern GUI using our latest tool Create. So at the end of this video you will be able to create a form somewhat like this. As you can see, it has a modern looking box and also it has a modern looking button which is working. So this entire project has been created with our tool which is Create, and this framework we are using is Tkinter. So let's have a look at the requirement for this project. First of all, you need to download Create. So just go over to this website which I will be linking in the description, and then move over to this code and then click on download zip. Alright, that's great. Now it's time to install the required modules for this project. So once you have downloaded it, just save it in any folder. Now you need this particular module which is Ttk Themes. Now you can just copy it over here and then run this command on your terminal to install Ttk Themes. I will link it in the description. So the most important information is we have now our website which is proxlight.github.io. You can visit this website and you can hire us for more projects. That's great. We provide intellectual designing like UX and custom coding also. So with that being said, let's start installing Create on your system. So after downloading the Create, you will get a create-main.zip file over here on your folder. So what you want to do is extract it. So click on over here and just choose extract here, and you can see we got a folder over here. So let's open it up and we can see a lot of file over here. So what you want to do is first of all install the Ttk Themes on your system. With that being said, just open up this create.py. So an alternative method is also there which I will be showing you, but if you want to directly open it over here, then you can just double click on this to run it. So let's have a look at the second method of running this py file. First of all, open up your command prompt and then change the directory to the folder where the files are housed. And as you can see, I have my file over here. So now you need to run it. So first of all, cls to clear everything. Now you need to run it. So just type in Python and our application name, which is create.py, and hit enter. Now the main thing you have to note here is it doesn't have a GUI, but it creates beautiful GUI. So you need to first of all enter your app name. In this example, we will be creating a page. So let's say app for instance, and then hit enter. Now you need to enter a size for your app. So just type in 1000, you may choose anything, X, and then 600 for myself. That's great. Let's hit enter. So if you want to make your app responsive, then you can just hit Y, or if you don't want to make it, then N. If it is responsive, then it can be maximized to a size which is not fixed. But if you don't want to make it responsive, then it will be fixed over to 1000 into 600. That's great. For instance, it will be N for us. And let's select the theme for app, which should be dark. You can also choose light because we have two variations over here. For this tutorial purpose, we will be just choosing it dark. Now, as you can see here, we got a tons and tons of widgets. Now you have option like text, widget frame, button, image. Now make sure that this is the beta edition of this particular program. So it has some catches which are like image. So you cannot add image yet, but we will be working on it soon. So you need to just choose any one of these. First of all, I will be creating a widget frame where we can house all of the widget. So you can see that widget frame is at 2. So just type in 2 over here and hit enter. Now enter widget name. Make sure that you should follow the Python algorithm for that particular thing, because you cannot start with any numerical value. You can just start it with any alphabetical value, and it should not contain any special character except this underscore. That's great. So let's name it like frame1 and hit enter. Now you can see add widget to root or custom widget. So you need to just set the widget to the root. So just type in root. Now add spacing. So you need to add spacing over here. So if you have multiple value, then you should use bracket. If you have a single value, just you can just type 40 for instance. But we will be using multiple value, then you should start with and end it with a bracket. For example, in this project, I will be just choosing 40, 0, 0, and then the final value should be 10 over here. Then end the bracket, looks great. Now you need to add the row number. So for us, the row number should be 0 and column number should be 1. You can imagine like a grid over here with the row and column being separated by a 0 value and a 1 value. Add X spacing. So how much do you want to space your frame from the X axis of the coordinates? In our project, it should be 0. And for Y, we will be choosing multiple value, which should be like 50 and 10. Now hit enter and it is asking for the index number. So I think it should be at 0. And border width. So in our case, the border width should be thin. So I will choose 1. And as you can see, it has added the frame. You can see widget added successfully. Now you can run this application by entering 13. As you can see, we have here 13 is run final app. So you just need to type 13 and hit enter. And after some time, you will get a window somewhat like this. So this is the preview of your application. Now make sure that this is not the final application yet, but you can say that the widget frame is not visible. Why? As we have added it at the center. It is not visible because we have changed the width and the border to around 1. That's great. Now we can add our button and text over here at the center. Now we need to add our text finally. So just type in 1 and widget name. So let's say text 1, hit enter. And now add widget to root or custom widget. In our case, it should be custom widget. Let me show you. As you can see over here, we have created a widget name, which is frame 1. So we need to pass in this text over here to the frame 1. So just type in frame 1 and hit enter. Now add text here. So you need to add your text. Looks great. And you can also create sign up pages, but for this project, we will be creating a basic hello world. Hit enter. And now you need to just pass in the foreground color. For us, it should be white. If you don't pass in any color, then by default, it will take it as white. Now font name. There are many font, but we will be using color tube. And hit enter. Now over here, you can also pass a size and some special spacing like the bold, italic, everything. Now we need to align it at the center, so just pass in center. Now you need to add the row number. Finally, for this I will be just passing in 0 and column to also 0. We should set the Y spacing to around 50 so that it should be at the middle, and there you got it. So let's just type in 13 and let's have a preview of our application. And as you can see, we got a nice looking application with a hello world at here. Looks quite great, right? Now let me show you what you can add more. You can also add a button, entry box, bin box, and you have multiple options over here, and you can just choose any one of them. So let me show you how can you create an entry box. So as you can see, it is at the 5. So just type in 5 and hit enter and enter widget name. It should be like a box or entry, whatever you can do. For our simplicity, we will be taking as box. Now add widget 2. So we will be adding this widget to the widget frame, which should be our frame 1. Now add text. So we need to add text like enter your name here and 3 dots. That's great. Hit enter and row number. Now you need to just pass in the row number. So for the row, I will be just choosing 2, column to around 0, and X spacing, I will just set it to around 200. And Y to around 0. Now let's have a look at the preview. So as you can see, we got a hello world over here and we got a text box with a nice looking pink color border. That's great. You can also change this color by just manipulating the TCL file provided in the description. Looks really great. Now let's add some button. Now just type in 3 and you have 3 menus over here. The first one is normal button, the second one is ascent button, and the third one is toggle button. In this tutorial, I will be showing you how to use that ascent button. Just type in 2 again. Enter widget name. So like button 1, add widget 2. So we will be adding this widget right into our frame 1. So just type in frame 1, add text like click me, hit enter. And now we need to enter the row number. So in this case, our row number should be 10, columns should be at 0, and I think it should be at 300 spacing pixels. So just type in 300, and from Y side it should be around 10. Looks great. Let's have a look at the preview. And as you can see, we have this click me button over here. Now you can change the spacing between them by changing the Y value, and also you have several features, like you can also add a frame over here and a slider, progress bar. So this is it, how to use our latest tool Create in order to create modern application. You will find some example which should be helpful for you. And if you want to export it, then just hit 14 over here to export it. So for quitting this app, you just need to enter 15. But still, we are working on this project. This project is not yet completed, but you can contribute us by doing some custom code and sending it to our email, which is proxlight02@gmail.com. You can send it over there so that it should be helpful for the future videos and the development of this particular project. So I hope this tutorial was really helpful, and if it was helpful, then consider subscribing, hit the like button below, and I will meet you on another tutorial. Until then, keep coding.